Hi guys,
this is Sushant Kochar, and today we are going to talk about how cardio and weight training are different when we talk about burning fat and which one is better. So a lot of times you might have seen that people go to the gym, they tell the trainer whether I want to gain weight or lose weight. Trainer tells them, okay, if you want to gain weight, go and lift the dumbbells, do weight training. Okay, if you want to lose fat, if you want to lose weight, go and start running on the treadmill, start running on the stairs, start cycling, do more cardio. So they'll tell you to do more cardio to lose weight and do more weight training to gain weight. What I'll tell you is, even if you want to lose weight, do weight training, do more of weight training and less of cardio, because most of the people in the gym who want to lose weight are doing more of the cardio and less of the weight training, and we are going to see why we should be doing weight training, more of weight training than cardio. In this video we are going to see that. So we have talked about how body burns fat even after exercising in weight training, because of the muscle recovery in the previous videos. I'll link the videos at the end of this video, but if you want to search, you can go in my previous videos and search. If at any point of time in any of my videos you do not get anything, just understand that you might not have seen my previous videos, because almost everything that I talk about in a particular video that you might not be able to understand has been talked about in my previous videos. I think almost everything. So weight training burns fat even after exercise, while cardio burns fat mostly during the exercise. So the cardio that we are discussing here is mostly low to moderate intensity cardio, not high intensity cardio. There are two major reasons. First of all, high intensity cardio cannot be done for long periods of time. They should not be done regularly, I would say, because after doing high intensity, your body might need decent time to recover. And most of the people today in the gym are doing low to moderate intensity, steady state, long duration cardios. So that is why there is a comparison between the cardio that most of the people are doing out there and weight training. Okay, so now the claim is that weight training burns more calories or fat than cardio, than steady state or moderate intensity, long duration cardio. Let's take a case. A guy with a BMR 1500, maintenance something. So if you do not understand maintenance, my previous videos, I have explained them quite recently. Okay, so 1500 is the BMR. The guy works out 6 days a week for 1 hour every day. He does weight training, he lifts decent enough weights according to his capacity. He does not like work out for 5 minutes and take a rest of 15 minutes or 10 minutes. He does one set and then he takes a break of 1 or 1.5 minutes or maybe 2 minutes, and then he does another set. He has decent enough intensity in his workout and he does that for 6 days a week. So his maintenance is 1500 into 1.725, that is approximately 2600 kilocalories. I talked about, if you do not understand how this formula came, go and check out how to calculate maintenance calories in my previous videos. Now this guy has a maintenance of 2600 kilocalories. Now, there is another guy with same weight, approximately 60 kgs, BMR 1500. This guy does not do much, he just stays at home, does some minimum household work like getting the food from kitchen, eating and drinking water and all those things. So his maintenance is around 1800 kilocalories. Now this guy starts to work out and he does cardio, he wants to lose weight. So let's take some cases where he can be working out by, let's say, walking for 1 hour. So this guy walks for 1 hour, he would be burning approximately 200 calories. This guy, let's say, he runs for 1 hour, he would be burning approximately 500 calories. If you're weighing more, you might burn few more calories. If you're weighing lesser than 60 kgs, then you might end up burning few more, few lesser calories. Now, running for an hour, maybe continuously, if you're running continuously for an hour, that is not a feasible case for most of the population, especially obese population who are trying to do it for losing weight, which is most of the times the case. First of all, it is not feasible, and even if you try to do it, then you might have to take rest periods in between. You might have to take rest in between. So if you end up taking rest in between, you basically end up taking more time than this guy. That is just to tell you that you are taking more time to do that 1 hour workout. Okay, so this is very less feasible case. Then coming to a more practical case, which I think majority of the people end up doing, they walk for some time, they run for some time, or they basically walk for some time, they do some kind of cardio activity for some time. This guy walks for 30 minutes and runs for 30 minutes. Walking for 30 minutes burns 100 calories, running for 30 minutes burns approximately 250 calories, a total of 350 calories burnt in 1 hour workout. Okay, even if we take the less feasible, very less feasible case of a guy running for 1 hour a day, that guy burns 1500 calories. So this guy would be burning 1800 due to his old maintenance, plus 500 burned in workout, he would do 2300 calories for 6 days in the week. And on the seventh day, he hasn't worked out. So he would be burning approximately 1800 calories. But as he has been working out 6 days, now his body might be recovering. So he might be burning 100 or 200 more calories. So he might be burning 2000 calories for that day, because his body is already exhausted for last 6 days. So see, muscle recovery, it is not that cardio does not break your muscle. It does, but weight training does break your muscle to a significantly greater extent. So the recovery is more in this case than this, in terms of muscle recovery. So you might have other kinds of recovery in this, such as cardiovascular system recovery. Okay, so this guy burned 2300 calories on the 6 days. 7 days he burned around 1800 to 2000 calories, while this guy burned 2600 calories for 6 days. And maybe on the day when he was not working out, he might have burned 300 lesser calories, approximately 2300. Okay, now taking a practical case from this cardio example, most of the time people who want to lose weight are not 60 kgs. They are 80 kgs, 100 kgs, 120 kgs, 110 kgs. So for such obese guys, it is not practically feasible to run for 1 hour per day. They might end up running for 5 or maybe 10 minutes. I hardly have seen any obese guy running for 20 minutes, weighing 100 kgs or more. So we would take a practical example where the guy walks for 30 minutes and runs for 30 minutes, which is also a bit less practical, but we will take that case. So maybe a guy weighing 80 kgs might be running 10 minutes and walking 15 minutes, but we'll take this case just for the sake of burning more calories in the cardio example. This guy burned 350 calories. His maintenance was 1800 calories. 1800 plus 350 of burned in the workout would be 2150 calories. We would take an approximation of 2200 calories burned in 1 day. Now this guy burns 400 lesser calories per day as compared to this guy who was weight training with all the similar statistics: 60 kgs weight, 1500 BMR. Everything is the same. Just this guy doing weight training and that guy doing cardio. This guy burns 400 lesser calories every single day. Now that means, so we know 100 calories, 800 calories is equal to 100 grams of body weight. So this guy is burning 50 grams more fat, most probably fat, per day than compared to this guy doing cardio. So this guy will lose 50 grams more weight per day than this guy. So this guy will lose 1.5 kgs more weight per month than the guy doing cardio. And if these two guys were put on a right diet and workout routine for 3 months, then the guy doing weight training would be on a total burning 4.5 kgs more weight in 3 months than the guy doing cardio. Now, if someone at 70 kgs burns 10 kilograms of fat in a period of 3 months and comes down to 60 kgs, it is a decent weight loss. It is quite good weight loss. So now, so this guy is going to be burning 4.5 kgs lesser in 3 months' time than this guy. So this guy on the whole would lose 10 kgs in 3 months, and this guy would end up losing 5.5 kgs. So this guy will have to take 2 or 2.5 months more to lose those 4.5 kgs that this guy has already lost in the first 3 months. And that with the math, that done with the maths, kind of shows us that weight training most of the times end up burning more fat in a general population case. Now, so this is why we should be doing weight training. Now, coming to weight training takes lesser time than burning the same amount of energy in cardio, because even if this guy was running for an hour, 95% plus population cannot be running for an hour continuously. They'll take breaks in between, so their total time of the workout would be more than an hour, while this guy was just working for 1 hour. So they took more time. And the guy doing weight training has to put in lesser effort. Running for an hour or even for 30 minutes is quite exhausting to me personally, and I have heard that from a lot of people. So running for long durations of time is quite exhausting, while doing weight training where you're taking breaks after every set is not as exhausting as running for running or doing cardio for long durations of time. So this practically takes lesser effort, so you would rather want to stick to this routine, because this routine does not exhaust you that much. So basically, weight training would take lesser time and effort to give you equal or maybe more, not maybe, equal or more results in the general population. Weight training can help you maintain the muscle that you have or gain muscle if you are on the right nutrition. While cardio can lead to muscle loss if then for excessive periods of time. For example, people do it for 2 hours, 3 hours. Doing it excessively can lead to muscle loss. And cardio does not seem to have many significant impacts on muscle gain, while weight training seems to have a significant impact on muscle gain. But here, what I will say is, if you're doing weight training, then you should be, first of all, you should be concerned about the right nutrition in both the cases, if you're doing weight training or cardio. But if you're doing weight training, I would say you should be more concerned about the right nutrition, because it breaks down your body or muscles more as compared to cardio. So if you're not paying much attention to your nutrition in weight training, you are going to be harming the body, harming your body. That is also the case with cardio, but I would say that is a severe or bigger case with weight training. That is my personal advice, personal suggestion. No, gaining muscle can make you look good. Gaining muscle can give you take your make your metabolism go higher. Higher metabolism means your body burns more energy per day, because more muscle in your body means more energy being burned. So if you have higher metabolism, you can eat more food, you can get more nutrition, you can eat your favorite foods also. So basically, these are the advantages of doing weight training over cardio. Okay. So next time you take a gym membership and you tell your trainer that I want to lose weight, and he tells you to go do cycling and treadmill, tell him that I watched the Sushant's video and he educated with us, or he kind of shared what he knew with us, and he told us that weight training is superior for fat loss or weight loss as compared to cardio, given the same amount of time effort put in. So what I will say is do weight training as a majority of your workout, and you can do 15-20 minutes of cardio, preferably high intensity cardio, 3 to 4 days a week. If you try to do it regularly, if you like doing cardio, you can do it regularly, but what is you might want to recover, so you can do it on alternate days, so 3 to 4 days per week, preferably high intensity cardio, because it is good for your health. Better for your health as compared to steady or straight cardio or low to moderate intensity cardio, and it burns more fat even after you have exercise. So next time going to the gym, do weight training even for fat loss. Tell your trainer my name. Okay, so if you like this video, please like it. If you have any questions or comments, put them in the comment box. Subscribe the channel if you like the channel. If you want to receive notifications for my future videos, turn the notifications on. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.